buildings in Cincinnati's historic Over-the-Rhine neighborhood this morning. And one store that went up in flames has stood there for 84 years. We have team coverage tonight on the fire and the impact. News6's John London is live with our number two story. John?
Well, it was certainly a swift spreading fire, Cherie. The four buildings are interconnected. You can see that they are boarding up the front of Smitty's tonight. The owner's telling us that it must be torn down. A lot of merchandise in Smitty's clothing store. News 5's Allison Montoya was here this morning shortly after it started.
At 3:45 this morning, crews arrived to this. Smoke billowing out of Smitty's storefront and the windows above.
The smell hits you first, you know, and then looked out and it's just nothing but orange.
Two residents who live above Smitty's were rescued by firefighters. Nearby residents were also evacuated into the cold morning air to only watch the well-known store go up in flames.
I looked outside, and after the third truck arrived, it was already jumped up to about 30 to 40 feet in the flames. It spread within 7 minutes.
A third alarm was quickly called after the fire became more intense, and fire crews could only fight the spreading flames from outside of the building.
This is a mass extreme operation. We're defensive in the four properties, but we do have firefighters in the fifth, just making sure that there's no extension into the fifth property at this point.
And now with the daylight hours upon us, we're able to get a better picture of the extensive damage and what a fire can do to a building built more than 100 years ago.
These buildings are massive in size as far as how they were built back in the late 1800s, early 1900s. So we're dealing with large timber, a lot of wood.
Also in the daylight hours, crews are able to investigate the fire that claimed a part of history and look for answers to what sparked the massive blaze. And over the Rhine, I'm Allison Montoya at News 5.
And the answer about how this fire started remains elusive tonight. The owner tells us the buildings must come down tomorrow. The family's estimating that the loss here, this is according to the family, is at least $1 million. Now, for the neighborhood, the loss is profound. The community connection is such that Smitty's was considered more than just a clothing store. The sign beckoned business off Vine Street for 84 years.
I got customers from every part of the country.
Smitty's, one of those throwback 7-day-a-week full-service stores, as comfortable as a top-style hat.
You know, you buy it, you can wear it out. It's altered, it's ready to go.
Encouraging hugs helped Larry Ashford through this difficult day. He was 15 when the oldest of the Smith brothers took him under his wing. That's Sam, who handed the business down to Phil, then Roy. There's Larry as a teen, now the current owner. Never once had to ask for a raise from the Smith brothers.
He wanted to take care of the kids that worked for him and take care of me. So he said, keep it going.
It's all upended now. The landmark quality of place, the underpublicized aspects. Larry would lend money to the down and out, shelter, employ, and lecture them just like the Smith brothers would do. Seamstress Pam Morton showed up at age 16.
I had a duffel bag and trunk when I came to this town, and they gave me an apartment and a job.
The eyes of Over the Rhine are trying to refocus as if in disbelief. They're accustomed to squinting. There were so many lights beaming from Smitty's windows.
More lights on the front than probably bricks.
Locals like Jim Tarbell and restaurateur Joe Tucker down the street sense the end of an era.
Visiting teams come in to play the Bengals and the Reds and stuff. They'd all go shopping down there because there's stuff you couldn't get anywhere else.
It took years for redevelopment to transform a wide swath of the inner city. It took fire but a few moments to erase an institution.
The life of a good man when he built it.
And looking live again at the boarding up of what once was Smitty's, we're told Sam Smith loved this old business, treated people like family. Tonight, Larry Ashford is telling us he intends to rebuild nearby. We will hear more from him about that coming up tonight at 6. Live and Over the Rhine, John London.
All right, John, great job recapturing this piece of history for us. Now you can see a slideshow of images from the fire too on our website. It's WLWT.com. Look under our top stories.